Good morning, everyone. Beautiful sunny day, blue sky. This is gorgeous. We feel a little cooling off in the air, and that's exactly what we want. We were concerned with the warm temperature. And if you recall last year, warm temperature in March pushed the vines to wake up and start bud swirling, bud growing, and we had a cold snap, and we dearly paid for a warm temperature too soon. So it is nice to know that the cold is coming back, and to just slow the vine. On top of that, there is no frost in the ground, and we rely on this mega ice cube to keep things cold and to delay the sap flow. So let's hope it stays cold. Yes, there is some concern, and I think the concern is the weather change in general. You know, weather change affecting everything. Affecting weeds, affecting harvest timing, affecting pollination. We could go from excessive rain to a drought, and that is the kind of stuff that we have as farmers, being soybean, corn, dairy farmer, fruit, veggie, and grapes, we have to learn how to adjust and adapt. We're doing mulching to keep the moisture, to increase organic matter. We also are doing radishes in the row to bust the hard pan and decrease compaction, so you have more water, air, nutrient penetration in the soil that is used by the roots. The roots of the vines are everywhere, not only underneath the row, and actually we would rather encourage the roots to go deep everywhere. So, and you know, we could talk about this for days, but ground preparation prior to planting a vineyard is extremely critical. It is not simple as, well, let's take a shovel, dig a hole, and plant a vine. It just doesn't work that way. You know, there's a lot of ground prep, being manure, chisel, plowing, dressing the soil, planting cover crop, to ensure good takeoff of the vines. This is February. We are pruning. We started pruning actually a couple weeks ago. This is the earliest and the most that we already have pruned. I think we are close to 5 acres. 4.5 to 5 acres already done. We start with the whites because they bud a little bit later than the reds. And there is a lot of talk of late pruning is delaying bud break. So we certainly don't want to prune the reds and encourage early bud breaking. The whites genetically bud 2 or 3 weeks later than the reds. So that's why we feel confident and okay to start with the whites. Whites on site are Brianna, La Crosse, and San Pepin. And one thing that we are realizing, and believe it or not, even after 50 years of grape growing and winemaking, here in this climate, in, let's call it, the upper Midwest, we all need to rejuvenate trunks. Cold winters, pruning scar, drought are tough on our trunks. So as soon as you see weakness in a trunk, training a new trunk is a must. Rejuvenating the top of the cordon is a must. Don't be afraid to do that. Yes, it is extra work, and if you do not have deer fencing, you will have to protect the young suckers, the young shoots, with a cage to ensure that they are not eaten by the deer and then they can develop and grow. But rejuvenation of the trunks and the cordon in the upper Midwest is a must. And we see that, you know, a trunk might be 20 years old, 25 years old. It's starting to age. It has worked a lot. It's time to renew it, restart it. The roots are great. The roots are doing their job, and they are not suffering as much as the trunk because of pruning scar, exposed to a cold temperature, and so on. Speaking of weather change, we, not only us, but all farmers, soy, corn, are noticing, and it's nothing new, but it's happening more and more, and maybe faster than we thought. More and more weeds are becoming resistant to herbicide, including glyphosate, and that is a serious issue. We don't have the luxury to mechanically remove the weeds and the grass because we are on sandy loams, and we do not want to increase erosion. So we have a no soil disturbing policy for the last 50 years, and we've tried steam weed killing. It works if you have a small vineyard. It is a very timely sensitive. You have to kill those weeds when they are about an inch tall, you will achieve killing at that specific stage. If it's a little bit taller, you will achieve burning, but maybe not killing. So I think the steam is a great concept if you have 2 to 5 acre vineyard, but for our scale, we just couldn't keep up. So we have decided to not fight with killing weeds with herbicide, and we are going to be mowing the weeds underneath the row. So we have invested into a mower designed specifically for that, with sensors that will go around the post, around the vine, and get back into its place between the vine, and again skip around the vine, and so on. It does require a 70 horsepower tractor. It is a heavy machine, so better yet to do soil aeration, minimizing compaction, because that equipment will quote-unquote invite compaction. But our goal is to use less and less and less, and maybe someday zero herbicide, because of the ability to mow the weeds underneath the row. I think I have covered a lot of topics. Pruning is really establishing the next crop load, and it is not only about the crop, but it's about the longevity and the health of the vine. So you have to think ahead of where are the shoots coming for the future? So rejuvenating trunks, rejuvenating a cordon, position of the spurs, it's all quite critical. You know, anybody can harvest grapes by hand, but not everybody is capable of pruning. Pruning is learning, no different than tasting. So speaking of tasting, it is something we do a lot this time of the year. When we are not after winemaking, which is September, October, November, then it's time to make the different cuvées, filtering the wine and getting it ready for bottling, which is what we are doing at this time of the year. So we have a pruning crew taking care of the vines when it's nice, and when it's not nice, they are welcome to come and help with bottling. Bottling is Tuesdays, Thursdays, sometime on Wednesdays. We do 25,000 bottles a day, 50 bottles a minute. It takes a crew of five, sometimes six people to achieve that. We have about 1 million bottles to do. So there are many days of bottling, including wine and spirit, brandy, bourbon, whiskey, from the Prairie Fumée to the Scarlet Fumée, Saint Pepin, you name it. So it all needs to get into a bottle so you can enjoy it. So thank you for listening, and we'll see you again when we do the mower demonstration. I would say sometime early June, mid-June, when we can start mowing weeds. Thank you.